All right, I'm ready. What's happening? I have no idea what's happening.
My name's Anna. I'm the senior food editor at Epicurious. Don't leave your meatballs alone.
I'm Frank. I'm a professional chef at the Institute of Culinary Education. You probably know me as a level 3 chef.
Now we scoop.
I'm Mr. Pink Shirt Guy, and I'm a level 2 chef.
Just kind of weasel my way around until it kind of pops a little bit.
Lorenzo here. I'm a level 2 chef.
Boom, boom, boom. I always get a little ninja in there.
And I'm Rose. I'm a food scientist.
And here are all the answers to all of your questions.
About spaghetti and meatballs.
Let's do it. All right, here we go.
Why would you even
break a boxed pasta in half?
All caps.
Despite the screaming nature of it, I agree.
I wouldn't break it in half because spaghetti is meant to be eaten in a strand, a long strand, okay?
If you were supposed to break it in half, I think they would have made it shorter.
You can't twist with your fork. It's half there.
I cracked them in half.
When I saw that, I was like, no!
I think that every Italian grandmother would say that's sacrilege.
Now, the only time I could see this being like a legitimate thing to do is if you're using a tiny pot.
You have long spaghetti, small pot, break it in half, put it in a small pot, and it fits.
I mean, if I was in a dorm and I had a pot this big, I might do it, you know, but I'm way too old for a dorm.
This hurts my soul.
Oh. There we go.
Next.
Order up.
What is the stuff floating in the water after you boil the pasta?
The stuff.
Oh, it's yucky stuff. That's what I call it.
So by stuff, I think you're referring to the foam that can form on the top of the surface. And that's just the starch that's being released by the pasta as it cooks.
Water gets really starchy when you cook fresh pasta. And sometimes that starch makes bubbles.
Sometimes there's a little protein in the water that might make it seem a little foamy too.
But if you have a lot of stuff in the water, maybe you should check your water supply.
Oh, what kind of water are you using?
I love this game, I'm telling you right now. All right, next.
Did the level 3 guy really used the canned peeled tomato, ? Like, come on, you don't have to grow them or anything, but at least pick them from the trees yourself. Well, first of all, tomatoes don't grow on trees, okay? Fresh tomatoes are better in the summer.
Any other time of year, canned tomatoes are going to be fresher and more tomato-y tasting than the sad white tomatoes you can get in the grocery store.
There's nothing wrong with a can. I mean, it is there for you, and you can change the taste of it so it's not canny by adding a little bit of, what would Rose say? Rose would say, add something like a citrus, or I use the carrot.
You can add some natural sweetness in the form of, say, a carrot, like Lorenzo did.
Thank you, Rose. I use a grated carrot.
Carrot.
Next. Why do so many sauce recipes call for canned whole tomatoes instead of canned diced tomatoes? When you have a canned whole tomato, it's usually the highest quality tomatoes available at the tomato farm or facility, whatever we want to call it, because they have to be whole and intact and beautiful. When you are canning diced tomatoes, you can sneak in the bad tomatoes because nobody knows, because you can chop them up.
If you can find them, use San Marzano tomatoes.
Now, we have a can of San Marzanos here. They're from a special part of Italy, and they have a much higher sweetness content. So they give a really nice, soft, mellow, not super acidic kind of taste to your tomato sauce. I think they're fabulous.
Let's spike it. Boom.
Does throwing pasta on the wall really let you know if it's cooked?
Who asked that? Is that my mom? Did she put that in there? No. Throwing pasta on the wall doesn't really let you know if it's cooked. It lets you know if it sticks to the wall.
I tell you what, I have done that all my life. You can't really tell. It sticks because it's starchy.
When you have a lower grade pasta or really overcooked pasta, the starch is gonna kind of seep out of that network. If you throw it against the wall and it sticks, it just means you have overstarchy pasta that's probably overboiled.
It will tell you that it's cooked, but it won't necessarily tell you that it's cooked to the right texture that you want. Likes level 3 sauce, Frank, adds orange peel. Me, how could you? You know, this is a matter of personal taste. It's something that I've always added to my tomato sauce. Obviously, if you put too much in there, it's gonna taste like a fruit basket, and you don't want that. The basil and the orange go really well together. They complement each other. Sometimes the orange kind of lifts that basil flavor up, and that's what I want. Spike that sucker.
I've always wondered about the perfect moment to add the meatballs to the sauce. I have too.
The perfect moment, right? I doubt in life there's many perfect moments, especially to add meatballs to sauce.
I have no real opinion on this. Honestly, I just put them in right at the end.
Well, this is a case of personal preference. If you're cooking your meatballs before you add them to the sauce, you can add them towards the end.
Just time it to when you want to have dinner. Say you're going to have it at 6 o'clock, it's 5 o'clock now. I'd put it in, low and slow. It'll be delicious, it'll be done and tender.
Okay. Can you use chicken for meatballs? Of course.
Yes, you could, but it'll be very dry.
I don't see why not. Chicken's a meat, shape it into a ball, it's a meatball.
It makes a serviceable meatball. Chicken meatballs tend to be a little leaner, hence a little drier.
There's no fat.
And when they're lower in fat, you want to compensate for that by adding maybe some other seasonings and spices.
You might want to add a few more breadcrumbs or maybe a little more cheese to it.
And honestly, I add a little tiny bit of ketchup to mine. It helps with the color. It adds a little bit of a tang, a little acid, and a tiny bit of sweetness. That's Emily's line. She's the ketchup girl.
I like to put ketchup on because I'm a monster.
I'm not ashamed of it. I like ketchup, so.
Okay, Frank, why no anchovies in the sauce? That's a great question. I do like anchovies in my tomato sauce. I just chose not to do it in this one. I think there's a lot of background flavor already with having pancetta, with having the beef. I might use anchovies in a sauce where I'm not gonna use a ton of meat, but the meat gives it a lot of that heft. And that's what I usually look for when I put anchovies in a sauce. I want a little more heft to it.
A little spin, and... So you don't add pasta water to the sauce. Oh, well,
I do. In that case, I just didn't need the water. I add pasta water to the sauce if the sauce is a little tight.
So pasta water is like liquid gold.
And that water is your secret weapon to making your pasta sauce glossier and saucier and more emulsified.
And plus it adds a little bit of seasoning and you get some of that starch in there, but you don't have to. Half the time I forget.
I myself don't. Why? Because I also prep the water when it's boiling very salty. So the pasta's already salted.
Does adding salt to your spaghetti water make it better? Of course, salt makes everything better.
If you season your water with salt, then the pasta as it boils and cooks will get seasoned. Always salt your pasta water.
Like the ocean, like really salty.
It depends on how much pasta you're using and what type of pasta. If it's a thick, thick pasta, of course you want to make it salty like the sea. If it's like some egg noodles, watch out, because that will absorb it so fast because it also cooks so fast. Okay, salt does not help water boil faster. No.
I knew this one was gonna come up.
Oh, I didn't. I know who said that.
The salt actually brings the temperature of the water up quicker.
It's not really going to matter a lot, but if you have some serious salinity in your water, your boiling point is gonna be higher, and so it's gonna make the pasta water hotter because of boiling point elevation.
That chef put so much salt into the boiling water. Who knew you should add that much salt? Yes, I added a lot of salt to the water. The water for pasta should be sea salty. Did people not put salt in their water? Were they angry? Were they angry about this?
That's so sweet. Aw, can we just give Lorenzo his own cooking show, please? You don't want that? Next. I love my participation in this show. It's amazing. It's totally cool. I teary-eyed a little bit.
How do you not cry while you cut up the onions? My husband usually does it for me.
Well, I'm a man, and I've never cried in my life. That's how.
I am definitely an onion crier. I think some people are more sensitive to it than others.
I wear contact lenses, and believe it or not, those protect me a fair amount.
I don't know that that works for everyone. I haven't heard that it does, but I'm happy it works for Frank.
I find that a sharp knife generally helps. I don't know if that's true or if I'm just making that up.
And I chop fast, so I never really have a chance for it to go into my eyes.
The less you bruise the onions when you cut them, the less you will cry.
A dull knife, when you cut the onion, ruptures the cells and releases all of that kind of sulfuric acid. I'm not sure if it's sulfuric acid. Maybe Rose knows what chemicals make you cry.
There are some sulfuric compounds that are volatile when you cut the onions, and that's what's really causing the crying reaction.
You could also eat an orange. I'm not kidding you.
So, question. If I were to use onion powder instead of onions, is that an okay substitute? I hate the texture of onions, but flavor is fine.
Yes, it's an okay substitute.
Oh, I dig it. I dig it, because you could have this in your cupboard. You don't have to worry about anything going spoiled. You don't have to worry about the teary. Oh, answer to the other question. Use onion powder. Right?
No. What? That's not okay. There's two totally different things.
Real onions, when they cook and caramelize, get really nice and sweet, and that's nice to balance out the acidity of a tomato.
It adds a nice round flavor, whereas the onion powder is just going to be a sharp onion flavor. There's not a lot of sweetness in this. It's just dried onion flavor.
One solution would be to puree your whole sauce.
That's what my kids like. They don't like chunky onions, so I puree my sauce.
I'd also recommend trying some other aromatics, like maybe scallions or perhaps something like leeks or shallots.
Use this on like a rub for barbecue. That's when I would use onion powder because you don't want all the you can't stick onions on the outside of ribs. Although I would try.
Order up. Not an ounce of red wine was added to the sauce. I'm absolutely sickened.
I agree.
Wow. I'm sorry that you're sickened.
That seems like a little bit of a dramatization there.
But I also personally love wine in a ragu style sauce, especially if there's meat involved.
Especially for seafood, like a saucy seafood, like a cream sauce, for sure.
It's good. It adds like a nice depth of flavor to the dish, but it's not essential.
White wine, red wine, whatever you want, you know? I'd drink one with you.
Sometimes if I'm under time constraints, I don't have time to reduce the red wine. The red wine has to reduce all the way or else you get kind of this boozy flavor to the sauce. But I do add red wine to my bolognese sauce normally, and I hope you feel better.
I was taught to add oil, not necessarily olive oil, in water that is going to be boiled to avoid pasta from sticking together. Is it true?
Well, is it true that you were taught that? I don't know. Probably, if you're saying so.
Wah, wah, wah. No.
It doesn't stop it from sticking. You have to just stir the pasta. That's what's going to stop it from sticking. For the most part, the oil doesn't really do anything except when you take the pasta out, it stops the sauce from sticking to the pasta.
The sauce is going to slip and slide away. I think I actually said it to slip and slide away.
Just slip and slide away.
The last two. Oh. My mom says it's good to keep the stems growing in garlic. Is that wrong?
You're weird. No, I'm just kidding.
Under what circumstances did this come up in normal conversation? Oh, you're talking about like the green things maybe that are coming up out of there? I think it tastes a little bit more bitter.
It's not wrong if your mom says it, number one. Let's just clear that up. It doesn't make that much of a difference. Sometimes people say that the stems have a little bit of a bitter quality to them.
In a pinch, you could use it, but for the most part, either take the stem or the sprout out or just find some new garlic.
That means your garlic is getting so old that it's trying to grow a new plant. It's time to compost that garlic.
I take it out because it gives me, at least myself, gives me indigestion if I eat it. But yeah, good question.
Can spaghetti just be one long strand?
What?
What a question, I love it.
Yeah, sure it can. It'll just be really hard to share unless you're Lady and the Tramp.
It would take a lot of work to roll out a pasta dough to one strand.
Go for it.
No, I'm gonna get, no, because then it would be like a spaghetto, right? Spaghetti's plural.
You guys want anything more on that? Okay. That one's spiked.
Yay, okay. Was that okay?
Congratulations. Now you are spaghetti and meatball wizards.
Thanks for all your questions.
Keep them coming. I hope we're doing you guys justice.
You might not agree with me, and that's okay. End of the day, it's your food. You do what you want with it.
Please don't throw your spaghetti at the ceiling or at any other people.
And that's
everything.
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 Or, well, almost everything
there is to know about spaghetti and meatballs.
Does Anthony never blink?
Sooner or later, I might. I don't know why I opened him up all the way to do this. Oh, you win. I blinked.